Good morning, everyone. My name is Deepak Maurya, and I will be presenting on behalf of Dr. Shashank Punia. So, synthesis of materials. So, we are working on the synthesizing this meso and macro scale structures in 3D printing during aerosol deposition unit. So, as all you know that printing small structure is quite complicated and very difficult to scale them up. So we are using this aerosol deposition method to print this kind of structure, complex structure. If you can see, we can if you zoom this area, you can see how complex structure can be printed in this method. So we are using this method to print some multi-layer structures like multi-layer ceramic capacitors. So here is the one example. We printed this multi-layer structure using various materials, silver electrode in the bottom, then barium titanate, and then barium titanate deposition using solder method, and then again another layer of silver electrode. And so this is the top view of this structure you can see from here. And then we were able to measure the capacitance and loss tangent on this structure. So this shows the capability of this system that we can very easily make this macro and major scale structure. So the idea is that we synthesize this sodium titanate rods, and then using topochemical conversion method, we synthesize sodium bismuth titanate, barium titanate solid solution piezoelectric rods. And so we will mix this into the ink, and using the aerosol deposition unit, we will functionalize this. We will functionalize these nano rods, and then using the deposition unit, we will print on the substrate. And we can print in various structure. We can design the structure using CAD in the machine, and then we can print. And using laser sintering at the spot, we can sinter this material. We can fuse this. These rods together to get the desired structures. So this is the example of the multi-layer structure. You can see there's barium titanate layers and then nickel electrodes in between. So using our machine, we can make the ink of ceramic ink, and we can print the one layer, and then followed by another layer, we can print this nickel electrode, and then we can print this kind of structure layer by layer. And the good thing of this kind of process is that it will dramatically reduce the number of days involved in this process. This is generally multi days process. It takes 6 or 7 days to get a multi-layer structure. And so the conventional process is like this. These are various methods to synthesize this multi-layer structures, and then we stack together like this. So this is an example how this process works. There is a binder. We put the system for binder burnout. It takes a long time. We have to slowly heat the system to avoid the porosity in the material, and then fire. So this is the example of tape casting material multi-layer system. And so the good thing, scientific part of this project will be to investigate the domain structure, as we know that 70% of the properties of material are controlled by these properties. So using laser sintering, we don't get time to grow these domains to get equilibrium shape. So it will be very interesting to study the effect of this microstructural changes on the properties. So this shows the comparison of the time taken both the process. So we can finish all this process, which takes several days in just 2 hours. And these are the highlights. We are still working on this, so we hope to get good publication, and we are hoping to get to file some good patents on this. So the key collaborators on this is Professor Bob Moore and Professor William Reynolds, and the Oakley's Laboratory for the Neutron Refraction Health.